my eyes feel strange.
This place.
A tall woman stands amid a field of corpses, some fresh, some ancient. Desiccated skin hangs from some of the skulls, while others fester with maggots. The woman turns to you, bitten lips parting into a grin. She tucks a small bunch of black-red roses into a leather strap across her left hip and, preparing to curtsy, offers you a hand. She lowers herself slowly, deeply holding your gaze. Her hand is slight, her touch delicate. As she rises up to her full height, the corpses seem somehow to close in around you.
I am Radica, and you must be here for the same reason as I.
She pats the bouquet at her hip.
But you're too late. These roses belong to me. Looks like we'll have to find some other way to keep you busy. Oh, I do hope that little so-and-so hasn't been talking. Those chains were in a place for a reason. How earnest you are. I do love that in a man. Ha! As though you don't know. This is the one place in all of Reaper's Coast where blood roses actually thrive. I suppose you just stumbled in by mistake. Disgusting. How they keep our kind trapped here. We are the most powerful beings in all of Rivalon. Bracchus Rex knew that, and he populated this cavern with the bodies of those who stood in his way. Our way. I can only imagine all the terrible ways he mangled them before he finally killed them. Come now, darling. If you're going to talk like that, you might as well stop talking.
She presses her lips to yours. Her mouth is soft, her breath sweet. She kisses you gently, then harder, her teeth raking softly across your tongue. Suddenly, her grip tightens around you. She's holding you hard, too hard, hard enough to crush you. Her lips remain locked on your hardened mug. You try to pull away. You hear a low hum, getting louder. Before you realize what's happening, winged insects pour from her throat down yours. They ricochet around your mouth, a wet, buzzing mass, more by the second. Suddenly, all at once, they start stinging you from inside. The flies nip at your bones. They sting you and sting you and sting you. After you are almost completely spent, the witch releases you.
Bloody delicious. Tell me, little man, do you know why the soil here is so very fertile? Do you know why it's the only place in Reaper's Coast where blood roses grow? Very good. Lovely. I'll need more roses soon enough. Of course, you won't provide very good compost, but at least you won't be around to tell anyone.
You see a glimmer of hope flicker across Slane's eyes as he notices your approach. It's quickly doused with a practiced scowl of the oft disappointed.
Have you brought it? Or am I to remain a slave?
Slane rears back in eagerness, grasping the purging wand with razor-sharp claws. Before your eyes, the source from within the wand surges into his draconic form, filling him with a light so bright that you must shield your eyes from the glare. The blazing brightness dies down. Squinting, you now see no dragon before you, but the figure of a handsome lizard. A handsome lizard, his eyes still blaze, a piercing silver. A triumphant smile dominates his face as he bows extravagantly before you.
Slane, at your service. Neither. Both. I am a dragon knight, the last of my bloodline. Shifting between two shapes is our great... If everyone thought like you, this vile place would be little more than a sunny island. Perhaps before we're done, we can return it to such a state. Knowing such a steadfast and noble soul offers help to those in need gives me great comfort. I'd like to offer you the same. When you are truly at a loss, when you have no choice but to back down or perish, you will find safety. I am a dragon knight, aren't I? We have a knack for no...
Slane smiles at you and turns to leave. He takes no more than a few steps. Ancient wooden door. It also has...
This ship has the claim of a captain. Unless you belong to Sek Zapper, I suggest you leave. Yeah, right. Cap doesn't die. Well, since you are so polite-like.
I see flurries, and the air thrums. Could it be Slane? Look at him. He's coward, true to his word.
A pity they didn't just listen. All this could have been averted. Look alive. A hammer should be...
There you are. The escapee. I feared you'd made it to Reaper's Coast, but... Anyway, you're here now. You know, Dallas and Friedemann warned me about you. God woke. I'm afraid your journey ends here. You would only bring ruin to Rivalon. If anyone is going to become the next divine, it will be me. Do you think I enjoy this work? Taking people away from their families, fitting them with these collars? I abhor it, but I bear it. I can bear anything for the sake of the realm. It was the most important lesson my father taught me. Be strong, not because you are. Be strong because you must. For the realm, for your loved ones, for the children you'll never have. Please, don't make this harder than it has to be. It's not your fault, but still you stand in the way of peace. This must be the end of your journey, for the salvation of all Rivalon. You stand no chance, but I admire your resilience. Give it your best shot. Thank you.
son of Lucius! Murderers!
Quite the mess you've made.
I'm Malady.
She steps forward, grabs you behind the neck with alarming strength, and pulls you close. She sniffs twice, her nose at your ear, then bites, piercing the lobe with a needle-sharp fang. Ugh.
Undead and godwoken. Well, now I've seen everything. Well, I was trying to get a little taste of your flesh. I can tell a lot from a little morsel, but you're fresh out.
She leans back, looks you over, and smirks.
So, Godwoken, you're what gets some of us out of bed each... Well, first things first. Alice's little necklaces are loved. They're better. I managed to free myself.
She peers at you closely, a knowing squint in her eye.
Tell me, which of those little gods did you meet? And what...
Her eyes go wide.
Go on, then. Show me what... I don't. Now, like that.
She takes you by the shoulders and gestures for you to do the same to her. She closes her eyes, and a warm, soothing sensation runs from her hands into your body. Suddenly, you feel the familiar swell of source within you.
Perfect. You really are... I'm... happy. Oh, how unbecoming. Come then, we set sail. Your destiny awaits, etc. You'll have to ask the Meister about...
Malady beckons...
After you, darling. Let's go.
Malady
Godwoken.
Salty water.
Tired but victorious, the party. Vengeance. The horrors of Fort Joy behind them. They arrived as sorcerers. They're left as Godwoken. The fate of this godforsaken world now rested on their shoulders. Or at least, on the shoulders of one of them.
Looking down at your robes, you see they're damp with blood and the ocean's spray. In the distance, Fort Joy looms.
What were they thinking, standing against an Eternal? I almost pity the poor ignorant. Onward now! The sooner Fort Joy...
Gareth, we got what we came for.
I won't see them tossed overboard. Not here. We'll hold a proper sir.
What's his face and so-and-so?
You know that.
Gareth.
Our guest stirs.
Ah, our undead Godwoken. I had nearly...
Gareth nods.
Void Slayer, Worm Killer, Godwoken. You have many names. Let's add ship's captain to the list once we get this thing moving, shall we?
Undead is a name I wasn't expecting.
The Divine is the... You may not speak to him directly, but he... Driftwood of Maester Siva. She held the Seekers together when we had ev... I won't have to think that. Amazing. Other god... We weren't the... We found... But let's leave... She's not. I don't know, but there are...
Gareth.
Keep loose...
There you are. Please, don't.
We can't get this ship moving, Godwoken. We have every free hand looking into it. Help, if you can. Our entire mission will have been for nothing if we don't...
May the fallen rest easy in the Hall of Echoes. Keep Lucian...
Yeah.
Don't go any further, Godwoken. We need you alive. The ship won't sail.
She glances over towards a small...
That was Brendan. When the ship... Blessings to our fallen. Pray that they may find rest.